Hi everyone, and welcome back to another Food and Fun Friday. Excited to share another new recipe with all of you and some scripture reading and a story time. So if you're new, do me a favor and go right down there and hit that big red subscribe button and subscribe to the channel. Hit the notification bell underneath that and you'll be notified whenever I upload a new video. Share around this channel to help this channel to grow, and it helps me to help all of you. And definitely shoot me a thumbs up if you're enjoying all of these new recipes. Stay tuned, everyone. Great to see you. Great to be back in doing another Food and Fun Friday with all of you. Got another new recipe that would have been in yesterday's slideshow. We've got a pepperoni pizza pepper. Yum. I am excited to dig into this. Now, I always do the videos on the same day that I make the recipe, so that way I get to sit down and eat it, and then you just get the video late. I always do, you know, my videos pre-recorded. But yeah, I'm excited to dig into this one. And then if you're new to my channel, I do what's called OMAD, one meal a day, 6 days a week. And then on Sundays, I break that and I do like more of like a 12 to 16 hour fast, just kind of eat when I'm hungry, just kind of splurge because I'm in maintenance mode. If you're new to my channel, I have been ketogenic. This November will be 6 years. I started on November 5th, 2015, right before my 40th birthday party. My 40th birthday. I did have a party though, because it was for my 40th. But I started right before that. My birthday's in December, so I was almost 40 years old when I started. In a short 15 to 18 months, I lost over 170 plus pounds, and I have maintained that weight ever since. So almost 4 years. This April, well, when you get this video, it will be April, and I can't remember the exact date, but it was in April. That would be 4 years maintaining this weight out. I started at just 2 pounds shy of 300 pounds when I started, and I sit today between 135 and 140. I'm 5'3", if anybody is curious to know that. I went from a size 24 to a 26 jean down to a size 2 to a 4. I wear a size small to medium, but basically small and some extra small, and I was wearing a 3X, and some 3Xs were getting tight on me because I carried a lot of weight in my belly. But yeah, I did really phenomenal. I was taught though by a keto doctor, two keto nutritionists, and my brother who teaches this as a job. So I have been able to teach a lot of you. I am not professional, but I was taught professionally. So if anybody needs any help, link down in my description box is my email. I would love to help you. I myself have helped over 3,000 people get their life back doing the ketogenic way of life, because there's a certain way to do it, a certain key to it, and everybody's got to be set up on a different macro plan. I need to ask personal questions. So if you need help, send me an email and I would love to help you get started and get your life healthy again. When I started, I was right before, like I said, my 40th birthday, and I had major health issues. I was on 22 medications. Most of them were for a heart condition I developed back in 1998 when I had my son. I developed what's called postpartum cardiomyopathy, which just means enlarged diseased heart. Doesn't mean just. Very serious. I had the heart of an 83-year-old. My heart was only functioning at 8%. It was the upper left ventricle that was enlarged by double the size and only functioning at 8%. I was on a heart transplant list. I was put on tons of medications. I kind of just maintained out, never needed a heart, but the heart really only got up to about 25%. That is not good. A normal heart for anybody is around 50%. If you're anything over that, you're more athletic, okay? But most people sit around 50. I was only 8%. They had told me if it had been the right ventricle, it wouldn't have been as bad. Because it was the left, it made it worse. But I never did need a heart, but I was sitting at 25% for years and years. That's the highest I could get it. And I was on many medications for it, many. And during that time, I developed high cholesterol, high triglycerides, high blood pressure, high sugar levels, PCOS, HPV, stomach GERD, you know, vertigo. I mean, I just developed so many things throughout that time, throughout my life. And I was so young. I was only 22 when I had my son, but I had the heart of an 83-year-old. Well, I tried many ways of life, many different diets, many different ways of eating, and nothing changed. I lost substantial amounts of weight, I think once or twice. Some other times were just, you know, maybe 50 pounds. But one time I had lost over 100. I think one time was real close to that. And nothing was changing. I was still on all of my medications. And all of a sudden, the ketogenic came along. My brother got wind of it. Now, ketogenic's been around for a long time, but he got wind of it, and he wanted to try it. My brother, in 5 months, lost 150 pounds because he worked out with it. I couldn't work out. And it's my brother, Rob. His link is down below as well. He's got like a bulletproof page and all that, but he doesn't do a lot of that anymore. He's got a new girlfriend and everything for the last few years, moved. He's, you know, a family man. He takes care of his sons and all that. So he's got a lot going on in his life, and he works really hard and all that. So he's not helping as much, but he was very smart, did all of this, 150 pounds gone in 5 months. Now, it took me longer because I couldn't work out, which just means that if you can't work out, yes, you are still going to lose weight. I still did. I did it in 15 to around 18 months. I lost 170 plus pounds. And like I said, it's the best way of life. I started to come off of medications immediately within the first 3 to 4 months. I was still in the 200s coming off of medications because I was getting dizzy and really weird feeling all that because medications were not needed in my body anymore. I am now, today, I sit at 2 medications for the heart, very low dose, but my heart is almost 50%. I haven't had it checked in over 3 years, but almost 3 years ago, it was at 45, I believe. So I believe now I'm probably at 50% because I do a lot of fasting. Back in March when this pandemic hit, I started doing OMAD, and I've done it ever since. Every single day, I did OMAD for a year. Then I started doing OMAD 6 days a week and doing it on Sunday. I would just break that and still do keto, but just kind of eat what I wanted throughout the day, not worrying about fasting or anything like that. But I did fast through my whole journey. I just didn't do it in the very beginning. I waited till I was good and fat adapted, about 2 or 3 months. And then I started incorporating 16-hour fasting. So I would eat 2 to 3 meals or 2 meals and a snack, and I would stop eating, and then I would fast from like 7 till the next day, whatever it would be to make it to noon. I didn't eat till noon the next day, and that would be my 16 hours. And then I would eat my 2 meals, a little snack, and then, of course, again, stop. So I did a lot of intermittent fasting, you know, during that time too, because it helps skin and all that. Then I learned about OMAD, and then I learned about alternate day fasting. I started learning about autophagy, which is when you hit 18 hours, you go into a state of autophagy. Just like when you're eating keto, you go into a state of ketones. You produce ketones. You go into a state of keto. Sorry. So your body's just producing ketones, which just means it's a big word for fat burning mode. Your body's always burning fat for fuel. So we eat a higher fat diet, and we eat very low carb, 20 or less carbs a day. You can either do net, which means you deduct dietary fiber off of like your green veggies, or you can do it off of like sweet treats like this. You can get rid of the fiber and the alcohol sugars, as long as they're done with good alcohol sugars, but you can deduct that, and that's what's called the net carb. So then you're pretty much at 20 because you deduct that off the carb count, but you're really probably 30 or 40 grams. That's how I've always done it. I've always been a net carb. Some people do total carb where you would not deduct anything. You just do total carb. Would make it a little harder, but people do it. But I always did, net carb. And I just have had pure success, you guys, and I love the way I eat. Now, I also was taught by my doctor that when you get on board here with ketogenic, being a high-fat diet, a lot of people get it wrong and they think, ooh, high-fat, I need to eat high-fat foods. No, if you are overweight, obese, and have fat on your body, that is going to be your high-fat source. So you just want to lower that down. Instead of doing what they recommend is, let me say how it goes. It's 75% protein, 5% carb, and 20%, or I'm sorry, I'm saying that wrong. 20% protein, 5% carb, and 75% fat. So a lot of people, you know, they do the 75%, which is like 110, 150 grams. No, they do recommend that somebody trying to lose weight uses their body fat. That's what I was taught professionally, was to do 75 grams, no more than like 100 grams. Stick around there, use your body fat, and you'll lose it quickly, because a lot of people don't lose when they're eating 150 grams because your body, how is it going to burn that when it has its own fat? It's trying to burn its own fat. It's trying to burn the fat you're eating. So it will take much longer. If you want to lose it quickly, do what I'm saying, because you'll never get to goal weight if you eat tons of fat like that. You just won't. Use that body fat. That's what it's there for. That is your high fat source. So use the high fat and get to, you know, to your goal weight very quickly. And then you have to start incorporating fat, because if you don't have a lot of fat on your body, now you need the 75% that they talk about, or the 70%, 70%, 70, 70, 70 and 20, that's 70, 80, 90. So it is 75, 75, 20 and 5. So that's your 100% value of your calorie intake, which comes from protein, fat and carb. Okay, that's how it comes in. But you do not have to worry about hitting that macro of the 20%. You want to go under, I don't mean over. You want to do 20 or less. You can do carnivore and eat zero carb. We don't even need to eat carbs. Fat, if you have fat in your body, you can go less than 70% fat. I'm, you know, 75% fat. You can definitely go less. I proved it. And the thousands of people that have been doing it with me that I've been teaching also lowered it. So you don't have to worry about those two. But the most important is your protein. Protein is the most important. It's like basically half your current body weight. So if you weigh 300 pounds, you need 150 grams of protein a day. If you weigh 200 pounds, you eat 100 grams of protein a day. Now where I sit, I only need, you know, 65, 70 grams a day because I weigh between 135 and 140. So you will go down as you, you know, get lower and lower. But if you are working out, keep the protein a little bit higher. If you are working out, even if you are thinner, you know, instead of doing where I do like 65 with my working out, sometimes I'll do, because I do work out now, so now I did increase that to like 75 to 80 grams. Some days I don't always get it in, but I basically really try hard to get my protein in. At least, you know, like I said, like 80 to 90 grams now, because I do work out, but not anything hard. I just do a cardio and some resistance. So I'm not doing anything hard. But if you work out in a gym, you want to add even more. Okay, that's important. But if you need help, like I said, I'd love to set you up on a macro plan. If you're new to keto or you're doing keto and it's not working, I can help you. I can get you on board. Everybody that followed me lost their weight. Follow people that show real results, people that show it. You know, people that stall out for a while and stuff like that, you're not going to get those results. So if you're not 100% committed, then I wouldn't be a person to follow, because I'm going to kick your butt back into ketosis. I'm going to tell you the truth. No cheat days. No. You're not going to have cheat days. You're going to wait till you get to maintenance mode. I didn't have my first cheat until I got to maintenance, which just means off plan. And I have been ketogenic for almost 6 years, and I've only had 11 cheat days. That's right. In almost 6,000 days, I've only had 11 cheat days. And that was basically just for the holidays, because my mom makes a good meal and she wanted me to do it. But I didn't do it the first year. It wasn't until the second year. So I actually was over my, you know, my goal weight and all that before I had my first cheat day, because it would have been when I hit April of the following year. So of 2017 is when I would have had, you know, hit maintenance, and I didn't have it till Thanksgiving that year. And then I've had a few, like for a birthday for my son or for our anniversary, me and my husband. But I'm very big on not cheating, because it messes with the head, even as thin as I am. But I do recommend, if you get to goal weight, get to a good BMI. I sit at a 23 BMI, which is excellent. And because I do, I don't ever want to be that person again, because there is such a thing as an addiction of food. Being addicted to food, I was very addicted to food. Obviously, I'm 5'3 and I weighed 300 pounds. So I was very addicted to food. I sat and ate big bags of Cheetos every night, or big bags of Funyuns. I mean, I ate fries with tons of mayo and the burgers dipped in tons of mayo. Sure, we can have the mayo now, but we're not doing the carb with it. That's the problem. Fat and carb is deadly. Deadly. And that's why people are getting heart disease and problems with cholesterol and just, you know, just having so many health issues, cancers, all of that. It's another thing when doing keto. It helps with cancer. A lot of people doing that intermittent fasting, and fasting and keto can eliminate, you know, cancers out of your body, which is amazing. I did a video on that. Go into my playlist. I did one on the ketogenic diet. I did one on autophagy. It tells you all the benefits. So just go to the playlist under miscellaneous or my keto journey and you'll find it in there. Definitely go watch those videos. They're phenomenal and it teaches you a lot. And like I said, I'm not a doctor. I'm not a nutritionist, but I was taught professionally and I did a lot of studying myself. I watch a lot of people too who are doctors that do, you know, talk about the ketogenic way of life. It totally changed my entire life. Like I said, I am a complete different person. I am 45 years old and I feel better than when I was 16. And at 16, I never was a heavy child. I probably weighed 160, 170 at the heaviest. I didn't gain my weight till I had my child, where I gained all that weight from my heart condition. I was retaining fluid and I gained a lot of weight. I gained over 100 pounds with that pregnancy with him. And then I just continued to gain. I think I got up to like, I think when I started, when I got pregnant, I was like 180, I got to 280, and then pretty soon I was to 290, almost to 300, and then I would lose weight, gain weight, lose weight, gain weight. When you start a way of life, that's what it's called. When you start a diet, don't ever call it a diet. It's a way of life, way of eating, the whoa. It's the way of eating, okay? This is something I will do the rest of my life. Sure, once in a while, I'll splurge and enjoy myself. I don't like to, but I'll do it, you know, for my mother's sake, because she makes great food and all that. But it's important to get into your head. You don't want to cheat. This is a way of life. When you go into this, no, this is how you're going to eat the rest of your life, however you want to do it. But if you're not keto, then this channel wouldn't be for you. I promote keto and I love it. It's the best I've ever felt. My doctor said, you look phenomenal. You're doing great. Keep going. But, you know, I've tried many other ways and nothing worked but this one. I know a lot of people want to try it with eating like carbs and then, of course, going lower fat. And that's what I did. I just never lost it. I lost it and gained it back, lost it and gained it back. But I love the way I eat here. I never miss anything because it's a, this not only is an appetite suppressant, so you're hardly ever hungry, so it is easy to incorporate fasting as you go along. It also is a diet where you get to eat, you know, just so many great foods because you get the fat, so you don't have to eat cardboard when you're doing low fat. It also will help, you know, take away diseases. I mean, I cured everything, you guys. Everything I had wrong with me, I cured. Other than the heart condition completely going back to normal, it pretty much is. And now it's been 3 years. I'm going to get it looked at again. I bet you it's back to normal. So that being said, please get on board, you guys. And I say this in every video, but I get new people all the time. And I noticed I had gotten like 6 or 7 new subs. So I just wanted to explain to you, if you are a keto person or interested in dieting and losing weight, I'm here to help. And if you need, like if you've been doing it and you just need like almost like going to AA, come in and email me and I'll help you get back on board. If you're just struggling and having too many cheat days and all that, I'll help you get back on. But this channel is all about not cheating. I'm going to teach you not to cheat. Because come on, does this look like I need to cheat? I'm eating pepperoni pizza on a pepper, which is, look at how delicious that looks, you guys. If you saw the slideshow yesterday, yum, yum, cheese pepperoni sauce. I got 2 hard-boiled eggs with mayonnaise. I've got celery with real ranch dressing. I've got a yogurt here with some nuts, which is sunflower seeds, almonds, pumpkin seeds, and then a little bit of coconut pieces in there. It's a new thing. I'll show you guys when I do a video on that. And then I get to have a Quest cookie. Now, I'm in maintenance. I don't, you know, suggest people eating a lot of the treats. The Quest treats, I promote all Quest. Quest is all keto. They have pizzas, they have chips, they have treats, they have cookies, they have peanut butter cups, everything. Also, the Slim Fast bombs, not their meal bars, their bombs are also keto. So I would say that. But I waited till I got to maintenance before I did a lot of treats. If I needed a treat during the monthly, plug your ears, guys, then I would have just a bite or two of something and I put it away. Yes, I was that strong. I could just do a bite. But now I will have them in my meals. I don't do it all week long, but when I sit down to do a video with you guys, I incorporate a treat. I usually do a treat once a week, maybe twice a week or whatever. But remember, I'm maintenance. So I ain't trying to lose any more weight. So I can have the treats. But I would recommend be careful because these can be overwhelming and can make you just keep wanting the sweets. We need to get away from it. This is a no sugar, no sugar, no grain way of life. So you're not going to do the potatoes. You're not going to do corn or carrots or beans. You're not going to do anything starchy. You're not going to do any fruits other than berries, strawberries, raspberries, blueberries. Because no, am I saying fruits and veggies are bad for you, like potatoes and corn and peas and carrots? No. But what I'm saying is it's very high in carb and we do a very low way of life, a very low carb. So that being said, we're going to eliminate those things out because one apple is 30 grams of carb. We only get 20 a day. Okay. Raspberry, like if you get like 6 raspberries, it's 1 carb. If you get a large strawberry, it's 1 carb. Blueberries is a little bit more. It's about 3 or 4 for like a handful of raspberries, like 6 or, I mean, blueberries like 6, around 3 or 4. So they're a little higher, but still lower than an apple or an orange or watermelon. You know, none of that stuff's bad for you. But if you are a diabetic, your body does not know the difference if you're eating a candy bar or fruit. And I was told that professionally by a doctor and my keto nutritionist. So that being said, if you are diabetic, yep, you got to stay away from the fruits too. Get on board. You will eliminate your diabetes. You will take it away. You will eliminate other things that are wrong with you. It will all go away and you will become a happy, healthy person. So again, I'm here if you need the help. Now, before we dig in, I'm going to read my words of Jesus for women, which I always love to get some spiritual, some spiritual food in us before we go ahead and get our food in us. And I just did one on spiritual food. On my outfit of the day last week. All right, we're going to do this one. This one is called Slavery, John 8:34. I tell you the truth, everyone who sins is a slave of sin. And we all fall short of God daily. If you think you don't, then check yourself. We all do. Even if you get angry one day, that's a sin. And a sin is a sin to God. Doesn't matter if you kill somebody or steal a pack of gum, it's a sin. Or get angry, it's the same sin to God. And it goes on to say, have you admitted or accomplish your sin of slavery? Is there that one sin that keeps you locked in solitary confinement? Have you acknowledged it? Overeating, selfishness, pride, Sin becomes so attractive that once you give in to that one temptation, it is very hard to stop. Now look what it's saying here. Even eating, even being, you know, a person that overeats is a sin. Without really thinking about it, your favorite sin becomes a habit. Then after a while, that one sin isn't enough and you begin to do more. Sin is addictive, and can quickly make you a slave. Stop the process. Confess your weakness and ask God to free you from its power. And you can ask God to free you from it. Yes, we're going to make mistakes because we're human. But the more you pray, the more you get on your knees, the more you seek God out, the more you pray to him, the more you're going to live your life sin-free. You're going to try to be Christ-like. Christ walked this earth sin-free. Okay, we can try the best that we can. The more we pray, we don't want to sin. Sure, we're going to fall short, but I'm saying the more we dig into him, the more we want him, the more we need him, the less we are going to sin. And the more we repent and ask God to forgive us, we need to ask him to forgive us. He died on the cross for our sins. When he died, he forgave our sins, but we need to repent for them. Down below says, Dear Father, I've ignored it. I've justified it. I've lied about it. Now I face it. I confess my bondage to sin. This one that I can't seem to let go of. Help me to gain victory over it. Help me to bring it to you each time it really is, it's when it rears its ugly head. Thank you for your strength. In Jesus' name, amen. See what it's saying? Ask him and he will help you. If there's that sin you have eating or a sin you have, watching pornographic stuff, or if you have a sin that you are an angered person, or you swear a lot, or you smoke, or you have things in your life that you do. Go to God and keep asking him to help you with that sin, to get away from it. And believe me, one day you will. You will definitely get away from it and you will start living better. But when you start to slip and you feel yourself slipping away, and we all do, grab on to the Holy Spirit. Ask him to come in, grab on to God as tightly as you can and pray. This was really a great one. Start your day, go through your day, and end your day with Life's Manual, the Holy Bible. Read it, study it, get into it. Spending 10 minutes a day for the Lord. Get on your knees in a quiet room, which you can call a warrior room, a war room, whatever you want to call it, praying. In a closet, in your room, wherever you got room to do it. Go alone, close the door, and open up this word and pray to Jesus and open up his word. Give him 10 minutes. Did you thank him for waking you today? Thank him every day for waking you, giving you another life. You know, we're living in hard times right now, but they're truly not hard times when you're walking with the Lord, because God says in this book here, 365 times to fear not, where the media and all the garbage that we're reading tells us to fear. That is not of God. God doesn't want us to fear. He predicted everything was going to happen. All this stuff was going to happen, but he also tells us not to fear. So pick it up and read it. You're going to feel completely different. Get right, you guys. Jesus is coming back. He promised he's coming back to get his people, his Christians, those that have given their salvation to the Lord, that believe he walked this earth, died on the cross, rose again, which is, this is before Easter, this video. You guys are going to get it, Yeah, you'll get it this week. Yes, you're going to get it before Easter. So that's good. I forgot. I pre-recorded, but you will get it before Easter. Easter's coming up. It's not about the Easter bunny or the eggs, like I said in other videos. It's about Jesus' resurrection. And remember, he died on the cross for us and rose again. He took on the sins of the world. He was unrecognizable. He was spit on, ridiculed, called the King of Jews, whipped, everything, and hung on a cross to suffer for all of our sins. God sent him to do this because God loved us so much. John 3:16, for God loved us. For God loved the whole world. For God so loved the world. I get chills when I say that he loved every one of us. And he wanted every one of us to make it to heaven. And we all can have our salvation if we believe, repent, and get right. Then you have your salvation and you can know for sure, 100%, that you're going to heaven. If you don't know and you don't know how to do it, again, my email is linked down in my description box. Come in and I will help you get right with the Lord. Get right. He's coming back. You don't want to be left in tribulation. If you missed that, go into my Sunday sermons, and I did it on tribulation. I did 3 separate videos on what's going to happen if you get left behind and have to serve purgatory. You're not going to want to do it. It'll be the hardest thing in the world to be a Christian and be able to make it to heaven then. So please, you guys, get right with the Lord. Please, please, for me today, get right with the Lord. Or not for me, sorry. Not for me. Humble myself, girl. Why would you say for me? For the Lord. Get right for the Lord. Because he wants you in heaven. The road to heaven is narrow and the road to hell is wide. Look at the things that are going on in our world right now. It is so evil. God's wrath is going. That's why it's happening. But he's protecting his people. He definitely is protecting all of us. So just get right with God, you guys. Please, please get right with him. All right. What beautiful verses. What a great thing, too, because it talked on addictions. And I was just talking about food, helping people to get right. I had a food addiction, you know. I smoked, you know. I still do, but I'm cutting way down. I'm almost to the point where I'm almost done. And I'm just so happy because I've been praying about it so much for God to help me to quit. And I am down to, like, 4 cigarettes a day. And I was at a pack. There was one time I smoked 2 packs a day. Then I was down to a pack and a half, then down to a pack. But I'm down to like 4, maybe 6 a day, but around 4 to 6 a day. So I'm almost there. And I also switched over to the American Spirits. They're a little bit more expensive, but I'm smoking less because they just have the nicotine and, of course, the tar. They don't have all the additives that cigarettes have because I want to quit and I don't want to have such an overwhelming on my plate. But God, I know, is going to help me, and I'm almost there. I can't wait to tell all of you guys when I've been like 2-3 weeks free of cigarettes, and I know I will. But, you know, again, something I'm asking God to help me with every day, and I know He is. And He does understand. God understands we sin, and He's helping me. I know He is. So get right and get your sins right with the Lord, you know. Check yourself. What do you got in your life that's going on that you need to check? And God, you know, and ask the Lord to help you and to ask for forgiveness. Can't get to heaven without going through our good Lord who died on the cross for us. So, all right. I have got one meal here. This is my one meal I'll be eating today. I'll go over it with you guys. So I've got my pepperoni pizza peppers. I did the video yesterday. Go in that slideshow and you'll see how to make it, but I'll also link it down in this box. Super easy. It's just peppers with mozzarella cheese, pizza sauce, pepperonis, and Parmesan and red crushed pepper. And then I've got 2 hard-boiled eggs with a little bit of mayonnaise on it. I've got my yogurt here with my nuts. Like I said, a serving of nuts. I've got my cookie, my celery with a serving of ranch, if you see it in there. And then some whipped cream for my yogurt. And then I've got a Earl Grey decaffeinated tea with MCT oil in it, a tablespoon of that for extra fat because I'm in maintenance. And then a can of American Clear Peach water. That's what it is, their waters. So what I have here for carb. These are 6 carbs for 2 of them. For 1 full pepper with the cheese and everything, they are only 6 net carbs. So I got 6. With these would make it 7, 8, 8. And then this is 5. So 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Celery in that would be 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. With the nuts, make it 21. And with this, so basically I do have 22 carbs here, but I do one meal and basically I keep it between 15 and 20. Today we're a little bit over, but I think I'm counting wrong because these are a half. So yeah, these are a half. I'm sorry. So for 2 eggs, it's only going to be 1 carb. So 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 for the celery. That's right. 17, 18. And then I did a serving of that. 18, 19. Sorry, it's only 1 for that. 19, and then with this, 20. So I am at 20. I'm sorry. I am at 20. I knew, I thought I couldn't be at 22. I am at 20 carbs because I forgot I did a serving of this. The ranch, I did half a serving, so it's 1 carb because you can see it's only a half a serving down in there, and I never eat it all anyways. So yes, I am at 20. I'm very good at keeping at 20. I thought, wait a minute, how did I go over? But even if I did by 2, that's not going to do anything when you eat one meal because I'm going 24 hours with no food after this. So how's everybody doing? So great to see all of you. I've missed you all. I know I do a lot of talking in the beginning, but I just want to help and teach. And yes, I know a friend of mine, Tammy, I believe it was saying, you know, you repeat yourself so much, but thank you for doing that because I'm always getting new people. So I repeat myself so I can help those new people out. All right, first we'll try one of our hard-boiled eggs, which I know is going to be good. Mmm. I got some pink salt on it and pepper. And now, let's dig into this. Pepper, or, I've been saying it wrong. No, I haven't been saying it wrong. Pepperoni, pizza, pepper. PPP. Pepperoni, pizza, pepper. Look at that. Oh my gosh, you guys, doesn't that look delicious? Don't worry, she'll find it, Minnie. Mmm. Wow, is that good. Oh my gosh, that's so good. Who needs crust? Who needs a crust on a pizza? Oh my gosh, this tastes way better. Using the pepper as your crust. There's so many different ways to do a crust. So you can make it with almond flour. I've got lots of recipes. Go into my playlist under my keto style mukbangs and recipes. I have made different types of pizza with flatbreads. I've made the bread. I've made it with egg and cheese. There's a cream cheese version. There's a fathead pizza. There's so many different ones. But this time I'm doing it with a pepper. So So like a stuffed pepper is basically, but I have it split in half here so we can have it laid out like a piece of pizza. You probably could even pick it up like a piece of pizza. And I did do a serving on each one. There is a serving on each one of the pepperoni, which a serving is 15. So there's 15 on each, but I lay it on the bottom and lay it at the top. You've probably seen the video. If you didn't, you'll see how I did it. And I'm wondering if you could just pick it up like a pizza and eat it. Yeah. Once it's cooled down, you can. You can pick it up just like a pizza and eat it. So just have a napkin handy. But yes, you can just pick it up. Whoops, whoops. Don't want that to fall on my pants here. We don't need to stain these up. I'm wearing my jumper here that I wore in a video a ways back. I got it at Target. Isn't that cute? Let's have some celery here. Oh, I just bit my side. Mmm. Love celery and ranch. It's really great when you're doing like a pizza or wings. Mmm. I'm trying to think of, so you can hold it like that, like a pizza. I'll see you. Now, this would be a little higher fat only because of the pepperoni. The pepper isn't high. Mozzarella cheese is low in fat. So you could have that. But if you want to change it up and still do this but be lower fat, then get turkey pepperonis. They make turkey-style pepperonis, and they're really good. So just do turkey on it instead. Or do ground turkey in place of it, or do, you know, something that would be lower. Do turkey bacon if you want. You know, there's different ways you can make these. That would make it lower fat for you. My story now. I always got to try to come up with one because I told so many in my life. Not so many in my life, so many on here, I mean. Let's see. I hate when I can't think of one. I had one in my head, I can't remember. Well, I have one in my head, but it's a little bit sad. Maybe I'll tell you this guy's a story, but it's a little bit sad. I have a cousin that isn't doing good. If you guys could keep her in your prayers. She isn't doing good. She was told, the doctor said she only has a week or two left to live. And it's very sad to me because I grew up with her, and that's kind of the story I was going to tell you, just some stories of me and her. And hopefully I don't cry. But she was one of my very close cousins that I did a lot with growing up, me and my brother Tommy, my youngest brother. But she's not doing good. She's got a lot of health issues going on right now. She's not doing good. And a lot of it, you guys, is to do with weight. It's important that you get healthy because weight will take you. She's only in her 40s. She's older than I am, but she's only in her 40s. But anyways, I'll tell you a couple stories. Me and my brother used to go over there, and we always had so much fun. We would play games with her, and we did this one game that you can do online, and it's... I can't remember the name of it, but it's a I believe it is a board game. I think it's called Nightmare. And there's different versions. But we had so much fun doing this, and I remember this one question was you had to stare at somebody, do a stare down, and she was so good at that. And you had to do it while the guy was still on the screen. You could not blink while the guy was on the screen. If you blinked, then you know, you didn't succeed. Well, of course, I was doing it with her. My brother did it with her. She made it through. Even after we blinked, and you can stop right there then, she kept doing it. Even past him coming on the screen saying it's done, we had to pause it because we were laughing because she just kept doing it. I don't know how she kept her eyes going like that. without blinking. It was unbelievable. But there was a story sometime where I was pregnant with my son. I was 5 months pregnant, and I was having issues with his father. I don't know if you guys know anything about his father. His father passed away last year. Year before, sorry. In 2018. I believe it was 2018. Gosh, has it already been that long? Either 2017 or 2018. I think it was 2017. My son never knew him. But anyways, we were having some issues. I was 5 months along. I hadn't seen him in a while. Once he found out I was pregnant, he was living with me and my family. He tended to just, you know, move out. He wanted to go back home, moved out. Found out he wasn't even a great dad to the first kid he got pregnant, the woman he got pregnant. Hardly was even in his life. I didn't even know he had a kid till after I got pregnant. We were engaged. I was not trying to get pregnant. I actually was just only a week or so late on getting my depo shot. And I ended up getting pregnant. He just kind of distanced himself afterwards. And I acted like he was really happy that I was pregnant. But it was funny how he wanted to move out. He didn't want to stay there anymore. I don't know. But this was a Valentine's, and I was 5 months pregnant. He hadn't seen me in a couple months. And of course, when he seen me, he was, wow, you really popped out. I'm like, well, yeah, you haven't seen me for almost 3 months or whatever. And I said, I'm like going on 6 months pregnant. And at that time, I was developing a heart condition I didn't know about. So I was gaining even more weight. But anyways, he came over. I was at my cousin's, the one that's not doing well. I was over there. And he was coming to see me to take me out for Valentine's Day. He took me out, came back. We had a nice dinner together, but it was just kind of weird. I felt it was weird. He came back. He goes, I got to drop you off because I got to get to work. So I trusted him. I said, okay. He forgot something. So I called. Back then, we didn't have phones to be able to call people. Back when I first met him back in 98. We didn't have cell phones. And if they did have them, then we didn't have one. So I couldn't get hold of him. So I called his work and they said, he doesn't work here. Or doesn't work today. He doesn't even work here anymore. Yeah, I was not happy finding out he lied. Another lie he had told me. I thought, this is it. I cannot be with a guy like this. I cannot raise this child, let my child go through this. Because he did such bad with his first child. His child was always sad. Done. That was so good. His kid, I mean, would even ask me, he's 5 years old, and he would say, how come my daddy doesn't love me? And I was already pregnant then. But anyways, he came over, and so of course I'm trying to get a hold of, you know, his parents or whatever. I'm crying, I'm upset. I was just saying, just calm down, just relax. Everything's fine. There must be an, you know, explanation. Maybe he was working at a different job. No, he lied. So she got a hold of him, or somehow he got home, and he came right back because I said, I don't want to be with him. I'm not going to stay with him. I will have this baby alone. He came over. I was crying. I'm like, I don't want you anymore. This is done. You're not going to be any part of this child's life. I'm not going to let you ruin, you know, this, my baby's life. I knew at the time I was having a boy. I said, you're not going to ruin his life. I'm not going to let you do this. I don't want to be with you anymore. And I was at my cousin's. We were having a good time there, but now I'm in tears because of him. And my brother Tommy, who was very protective of me, was 15 at the time. I was 21. And he was 14 or 15. And he came, heard me fighting, and I said, don't touch me, because he had pushed me to the ground. You know, kind of not hard, but set me down because he wanted to talk and I wouldn't talk. And he kind of grabbed my arm and set me down really quick. And I said, don't, you're going to hurt me. Hurt the baby. You're going to kill this baby. That's what I said. And I heard my brother, Tommy, come running. Because I was just down one floor. She lived in an apartment. And the door was open. My brother was listening. So he came to the top of the step, started to come down. He said, leave my sister alone. You're going to kill that baby. And he looked at him and said, and you're going to die of high cholesterol, you fat F-U-C-K. My brother wasn't even very much overweight then. Maybe, I don't know, maybe weighed 200 and he was 15. Pretty tall too. But he told me he was going to die of high cholesterol. And then my brother said something else. And I don't know what it was, but he chased after my brother. He went after my brother. My brother ran, went to my cousin, shut the door. And I screamed, leave him alone. He came back to me and said, let's talk. I said, no, it's done. It's over. Get away from me. Leave. I don't want you. And we're done. And that was it after that. I never ever communicated with him anymore until my son was born. We got a hold of him to say the baby was born. Did he want to come and see me? He said, yeah, I'll get over there as soon as I can. 10 years later, he's seen his son once when he was almost 10. Once. Never gave me anything for him, never helped me, was always running from the law. They were always trying to find him to get child support from him and everything, and they could never find him. He worked things under the table. And, well, karma, which is God, came along and got him. Because he ended up with a brain tumor and ended up on Social Security. Well, kind of sucked for me because they said that he didn't have to pay anything, didn't have to pay any back pay. Whatever. I didn't want nothing from him. I was never fighting for it. I just said, I'll raise my son by myself. I don't want nothing from him. What's that? So, not saying in a bad, you know, way or whatever, but the brain tumor didn't take him. He did live through that. But he did end up later on in years with a problem with his pancreas, I believe. He had pancreatic cancer. And that took him. My son was very sick. My son had never really got to know him. I guess he was kind of seeking him out. Our son was almost 18 at the time. Maybe wanted to know why he was never part of his life. And then he found out he died. Well, God allows things to happen for a reason. Maybe he wouldn't have heard what he wanted to hear and it would have hurt my son even more. But just shows you, be careful in life. But the moral of this story was how much fun we had at my cousin's. And it just so happened that this had happened during the time I was at my cousin's. But we went over there almost every weekend. We had so much fun. And I just didn't want to get too emotional to talk about her because I don't know how much time she has left. They said a week or two. And so I don't want to get too emotional. I am going to go see her tomorrow. I haven't seen her for a while. It's been a while because, you know, when you get older, you do things and life gets busy. So I feel really bad, and this might be the last time I see her, and now I can feel the tears welling up. Possibly will be the last time I'll see her. We are also going to go visit my brother-in-law. He also is not doing good. He developed colon cancer a couple years ago, and they did different things on him, chemo and stuff, and he seemed to do okay, but it turned around for the worse, and there's not much they can do for him anymore. And he had a procedure done a couple days ago, and he was going home on hospice, and they said the same thing. He has a week to days to live. So right now, we're going through some hard times. So we're going to go visit him and go visit my cousin. I just ask that you keep both of them in your prayer, keep the family in your prayers, because I can't imagine, you know, his sister going through something like this, losing her husband and stuff like that. So if you could just please keep me in your prayers. But yeah, they mean a lot to me. But my cousin, she was one I hung out with the most. Me and my brother did. We did so much with her. And I'll never forget those memories. I will take those memories with me forever. I will lock them in my heart and hold them dearly. Because she was the one I hung out with the most. This is the raspberry one. But yeah, we hung out the most. Had so much fun. I remember many nights spending the night with her when I was younger. We're only a few years apart. I think 3 or 4. A lot of good memories. I don't know why, but I was very close to her out of all my cousins. And she will be missed dearly. I love her dogs. I love what she said when I got Minnie. She said, she's so cute and pretty, but I'm going to tell you right now, she's going to be very prissy. She could tell just by a photo, and my dog is very prissy. So, but yeah, I had a lot of fun with her. We did many things together, many vacations together, many weekends we spent with her. Then my brother started coming along with too. We had a lot of fun. So I don't know if she watches these videos, but if you do, I love you, sweetheart. And I thank you for all the memories we have. And I'm still praying for you, you know. God is ultimately in charge of our time when it's over. So I'm still praying for you. And I'm going to come and see you tomorrow. But it may be the last time I see her. So if you just keep me in your prayers and hold dear to people in your family that you are close to, because time just went by and I've lost many years with her now. Many years, you know, because you get married and things happen and I don't see her very often now. But I have a lot of good memories. Lots and good memories. We made fun foods together. We played lots of games. We just had a lot of fun. Went on a lot of vacations. So I will miss her dearly when she is gone. I know, you know, every one of us one day have to die. So I will miss her, but just keep me in your prayers and keep the family in your prayers and for my sister-in-law, for her husband too. And no, it's not the COVID, you guys. One was colon cancer. The other one, my cousin has got problems with weight. It's destroyed. She's having kidney failure, heart problems, breathing problems. It's affected her bad. So try to get your health right. Because God gives us one body to take care of. And love everybody every single day. I'm going to get off of here. I'm going to finish the rest of this stuff off because it's getting kind of long, the video. I'm going to get off of here. But just remember to keep... I'm also getting a little bit emotional here. So keep the people you love dearly in your life close to your heart. Pray for them. Spend time with them. Do what you can. Because we're here and we're gone. We're a vapor. That's it. We're here and we're gone. Get right with God too. Make sure you're right with God so you know where you're going when you die. I love all of you guys very much. Everybody take care. God bless. And I'll see each and every one of you in my very next upload.